Hey, this is Keith Price for Keith Price's Curtain Call, and I just wanted to give you a little bit of a heads up. I got to go to Feinstein's 54 Below the other day to do a whole bunch of really great interviews, and one of them is with the fantastic two-time Tony Award-winning Norbert Leo Butz, who's going to be doing his show there August 5th through the 12th, and it's called Girls, Girls, Girls. Now, this show is so insanely fabulous, and he is insanely fabulous. The only thing that makes me so upset for you and for me was that in the first 2 minutes I was having such a weird time trying to get the sound thing to work that for some reason there's a little bit of a weird hiss hum thing going on, but I promise you by minute two it is gone and you can enjoy all of my conversation with Norbert Leo Butz. I just had to tell you because I don't want you to tune out. He's so fantastic and he's so cool, and I'm telling you, he's absolutely everything. So hang on, this is going to be a fun interview. Take it away. You are listening to Keith Price's Curtain Call. This is Keith Price for Keith Price's Curtain Call, and we are at Feinstein's 54 Below for their big press up fronts, and I am now sitting here with two-time Tony Award winning rocker, because you're a rocker. This man is a rock star. If you have not seen him ever perform, shame on you. You need to get on the Google, because this man is going to do like everyone here at 54 Below does, which I love, is he's going to turn you out. How you doing, Mr. Norbert Leo Butz?
I feel good, man. It's a lot of fun. I love doing this show. It's a lot of fun. These guys are we've been friends for a long time, these guys that are playing with me, and it's a great time. There's a great looseness about it, you know?
The thing I love about you that I have had the pleasure now of seeing you in a few shows is that there is a commitment that you make to performing in those characters, especially like I lived for Big Fish. I lived for Big Fish. I was so mad that didn't go the way it should have gone as far as I was concerned, but I was like, you... Man, you really, that was one of those moments where it was like, I could tell, and it's for everyone, you, Kate Baldwin, the whole group, like you guys were in something that felt really special to you as you were doing it. Am I wrong?
No, you're definitely right. I mean, that show specifically, you know, a story, a really a meditation on death, you know? I mean, it was really about death, and I'd had a lot of loss in my family, and two siblings and a dad, all in like 5-year period for me, you know, right before that show. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I loved doing that show because I felt in this way like I got to spend time with my lost loved ones, and it was a beautiful, beautiful spiritual experience.
You know, and then
to have, you know, Susan Stroman directing, yes. Kate Baldwin, Bobby Steggert, soulful, beautiful, beautiful actors. That was a gift.
It was that show for me was the same thing in that it spoke to me because I had lost both of my parents within a 6-week period of each other. And so I was still in that grieving process and still trying to deal with that. And talking to Andrew Lipp and John August, the three of us in our communal moment, we were like, oh yeah, we've all lost our parents. And we were all having this. And I think for me, that's what made that show so special. But now this new show that everyone's going to be talking about if they haven't, because this has already been recorded, which I'm holding the actual CD for, Girls, Girls, Girls. Norbert Leo Butz, you're taking another slice of your life and putting it to music, aren't you?
A little bit, yeah. You know, this started off as kind of a... It didn't have anything to do with music at first. There was nothing performative in my mind. I didn't think about singing. I have three daughters, and I'm married. I was formerly married. I went through a divorce. You know, I have a mom, my mother-in-law. I have three sisters. I have... believe it or not, 17 nieces and great nieces. All of my primary relationships are with women or girls in my life. I'm more often than not the only man in my social circle. So I was doing a lot of reading at the time. By the time my girls were like 16 and 13, and they're now almost 19 and 16, and my youngest is 5. And I was doing a lot of reading on sort of adolescent development, female adolescent development, and led me to some sort of feminist writing. And I have a friend who's in the women's studies department at Monmouth College, and she's really, really smart lady. And she introduced me to this idea of looking at sort of Greek deities and Jungian archetypes and trying to sort of get at the sort of subliminal common denominators that are in different women. And I just found the reading kind of interesting. I hadn't read mythology, and I never did a course in feminism in college, and I've always been interested in different facets of philosophy. And so I was just doing all this reading. At the same time, I'd be on these long walks with my dog, and I have like 7,000 songs on my iTunes. And I'm telling you, this really strange thing started happening where these female-titled songs about different sort of feminine archetypes are coming through, you know. And I thought, you know, I'd go take a walk, you know. For example, I would spend a lot of time reading about the Greek goddess Aphrodite. I was in Paris a few years ago, and I went and saw her statuary in the Louvre and was really thinking about this goddess of erotic love. And then a couple days later, I'm taking a walk, and the song, an old country song by Kenny Rogers called Ruby Don't Take Your Love to Town. Yep. Great song that was written by Mel Tillis. And it's literally about, and Aphrodite, the mythology goes, had many, many affairs, mostly with like strong military type men, like, you know, the human Adonis, but Mars, Ares, Poseidon, these really manly war gods, you know. She loved that. She loved that traditional male and female energy. You know, she was a goddess of sex is what she was. And here's this song about a Vietnam vet who's had his legs blown off, who cannot get out of his bed. And the first lyric is, you've painted up your lips and rolled and curled your tinted hair. Ruby, are you contemplating going out somewhere? It's about this woman who's slipping out the back door to get some on the side because she has to make love. She has to continue to make love with men, and she can't with her wounded military man anymore. And so the lyrics, it just, I got a chill down my spine. So I kind of went through all of these different archetypal women that I was reading about, and I found like these amazing songs that I had, and we put a show together. And so it's this really cool sort of mix of Jungian psychology and rock and roll and personal family history, you know.
I love it because that's a take that usually in the cabaret setting no one really ever has thought about doing. Like, you just,
well, here's the thing, and this is that's more out of pure ignorance. Mm-hmm. And I have tripped into a musical theater career out of pure and utter ignorance. I'm a trained actor and I'm a trained singer. I never did a musical theater class. I didn't know any musicals growing up. My first musical professionally was on Broadway in Rent. I'd never been to a cabaret. If you don't know the rules of something, you can do whatever you want. And but in a way, what I have since learned about cabaret, and have seen a couple since, you know, have sort of gone back and I've seen Patti LuPone do her thing. I've looked at a lot of YouTube. I did an interview with Sandra Bernhardt last week and looked at a lot of her YouTube stuff. Now, she was doing some really edgy, cool shit back in the day, but it was smart. There was she was making political and sociological and statements about gender and sex and fame and fashion within the context of like pastiche songs, you know what I mean? A song can be taken apart and looked at in 100 different ways, you know? And that's what I'm trying to do with that, and tell you something about the performer. And in that way, I'm doing very traditional cabaret.
Wow. I love that. That's cool. Norbert Leo Butz, man, is here with me. And again, he's got this fantastic show that's going to be here at Feinstein's 54 Below. Go to Feinstein's54below.com for ticket information. It's going to be August 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 10th, 11th, 12th, all at 7 o'clock. Are you planning on sleeping any of that time?
I have to rest up because it's actually really hard to sing. It's hard to sing for an hour and a half without stopping, but I'm determined.
He's determined. And the title of the show is Girls, 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 and it's also the launch tour, if you will, of the CD that Broadway Records has out that's called the Live at 54 Below series, Girls, 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 which you can get online. Not as of yet, because I know people that know people that know people. So you can start looking for this online as well, so that if you can't make it to New York at any of those dates, this is an opportunity for you to at least have a little taste of Norbert Leo Butz live. If you go, there's another one that you have actually too, where I remember where you sing Georgia to your daughter, that he did here at 54 Below as well. And again, the guy's a genius. He is doing it, You're just doing it. And that's the best thing. And it's really an honor and a pleasure for someone like me to be able to sit here and have this conversation with you. So again, Norbert Leo Butz at Feinstein's 54 Below. Go to Feinstein's54below.com for more information. August 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 10th, 11th, 12th, 7 o'clock. And if you can't do any of that, make sure go to Broadway Records and get Girls, 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 because it's going to be available soon. Actually, it's dropping like in 2 or 3 weeks, I think. Yeah. It's dropping. So it's an opportunity for you to take him home, so to speak. Hey. Now I'm going to get in trouble with my partner. All right. Now, when we leave, we're going to give you a little taste of what Norbert is going to be turning out here at 54 Below, because he gave us a presentation. Y'all are not ready. So enjoy, enjoy, enjoy. And thank you, Norbert, for hanging out with me, man. This is great.
A pleasure, man.
Thank you. And we will be back.
Thank you. You're awesome. Man. Thanks.
I've been in and out of every honky-tonk in town, and I'm almost drunk from the drinks that I turned down. Well, you told me you'd be happy bouncing babies on your knee while I sit at home alone, and I've been bouncing three, and I'm tired of it! I'm gonna call myself a long pick a limousine. Well, believe it or not, it's the prettiest thing I think I've ever seen. There's a big bar in the corner, TV on the side. This baby's 60 feet long and 40 feet wide. Hey, driver, pull that car right inside the bar. Take it on back to the big old blonde who thinks she's a movie star. I'm gonna grab her by the phony ponytail, sling her round and round. She wakes up, she'll know she met up with a mad Mrs. Leroy Brown. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, the smokes are doggone thick, you could cut it with a knife. And the music's so loud, you could hear the same line twice. Well, hey, Leroy Brown, how do you like this big old pink limo? I just drawed all your money out of the bank today, honey. You ain't got no more! Ah! One, two. I'm gonna buy myself a long pink limousine. Well, believe it or not, it's the prettiest thing I think I've ever seen. There's a big bar in the corner, TV on the side. This baby's 60 feet long and 40 feet wide. Hey, driver, pull that car right inside the bar. I take it on back to that big old blonde who thinks she a movie star. I'm gonna grab her by the phony ponytail, sling her round and round. She wakes up, she'll know she met up with a mad Mrs. Leroy Brown. Yeah, 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 yeah. Hey, Leroy Brown, you think you're a big old Zeus? I've seen that lightning bolt, motherfucker. It's about this big. That's right. Come on, boys, let's get out of here. Let's leave these losers alone. Here we go. Yeah, 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 yeah. Thanks, y'all. We'll see you next week.